Hello, everyone. It's Phil with the Ghost Hold Real Estate Group, powered by eXp. This is Kevin Belzer, and we are in downtown Phoenix today. Kevin, where exactly are we at?
We are at 1307 East Campbell Avenue in Phoenix, Arizona.
Before heading inside, let's talk about location. Kevin, this area did not look like this 10 years ago.
No, it's gone through a whole revitalization. This is a historic area. The house we're at is built 1935 originally. And this whole area, what's happening is flippers are coming in, or people in general are just coming in and they're rehabbing the homes and bringing them up to today's standards, but keeping the charm of old.
Love it. And then another interesting thing to note too is that not only are the houses being flipped, there's actually a lot of vertical apartments going up. So there's just a lot of revitalization that's going on in the area. Yep. Now, location wise, again, downtown Phoenix, it's a really great location, but why is that?
Yeah, what's great about it is you're close to everything. So if you need to travel out of town, you're within 30 minutes of a major airport. The 51 is, what, maybe a mile away from here. Shopping, conveniently located within minutes. If you're hungry, there's the Miracle Mile Deli that's right down the street. You want some Thai, there's Thai down the street. You want the culinary dropout, it's over at, you know, like it's on 7th. So nothing's very far away. It's right, like that, whatever you want.
That's enough.
You got it.
I'm hungry. You're making me very hungry right now. So that's it for the location. Let's head inside the house. All right, let's talk about specs in this historic home. Kevin, why is this so rare?
This is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. And in this area, this probably started as a 1-bedroom, 1-bath at the most, but obviously it's been, has had additions over the years.
Which is interesting because you can tell where the additions have been made, but a lot of these homes around here only have the 1 bathroom and sometimes only 1 or 2 bedrooms. So it's very unique in that fashion. Now, as far as one of the biggest upgrades to the property itself, what is not stuck in 1935?
Right, if we had to pick just one, it would be the electrical. It's been completely redone throughout. It's all up to code, it's good to go.
All right, let's talk about some of these kitchen updates to this home in Phoenix. Kevin, there's gonna be a lot of before photos that are flying through. What are some of the things that the owner did?
We have freshly painted cabinets. We have brand new granite countertops. You have stainless steel appliances, paint, flooring, it's all done.
Don't forget the can lighting. And then last but not least, one of the things with the kitchen is, you'll see this in the before photo, there's actually a large set of cabinets right by you.
Yeah, they didn't make sense. They were not upper cabinets. They were ones that, or they were upper cabinets that were put down.
Got it.
It made no sense. So we just eliminate them, and it just made the kitchen too small.
Perfect. All right, we're in the master bedroom right now. What are some of the specific specs on this?
The big thing about this one is the fact that it actually has a master bath. In 1935, this would not have had a master bath. This is part of the addition that was put onto the home.
Perfect. And then as far as the actual room itself, there's also new can lighting, carpet, any
paint.
Other updates?
Yeah, you got paint, baseboards, everything's been done. This is a top to bottom, it's not a lipstick on a pig.
Before heading outside, Kevin, what are some of the last few updates that were done to the house?
Well, we got new blinds, we have new vanities in the bathrooms, and we also had the tubs recoated, so they're all good to go. New paint throughout. I don't want anybody to think that we cheated and only painted like the kitchen.
Right.
No, the whole house has been repainted on the inside. And that's not even talking about all the cool stuff that was done outside.
That's a good teaser. Stay tuned. Okay, let's talk about the landscaping, all the exterior stuff that was done to the home. One of the nice things about this is that you're gonna see some before photos fly in. Kevin, what are some of the big ticket items that were done to the front?
The biggest one is right above us, and that's the brand new porch. Before, there was no porch on this home. It's just missing some character, so they had a porch put.
Perfect, and then as far as landscaping goes?
Well, they put the fresh gravel down, they removed some chain link fencing, some bushes and dead trees, and they put the nice brick paver walkway going out to the street.
All right, we're in the backyard now, so we're gonna flash some before photos in. However, what are some of the stuff that's been added?
This one, as far as the front had a new porch, so we're like, well, we didn't want the back to be lonely, so we gave it a porch too, because it never had one back here. We also, they had the whole exterior of the home repainted, so that's all fresh and good to go, and some new windows put in on the backside.
All right, so one of the things with this yard is that it was very enclosed in. What did the owner do in regards to kind of opening it up, and then obviously what's right behind you?
Well, there was property that belonged to this property that was behind the old fence line. So I'm sure they're going to drop in befores of that as well. We had it extended out to the actual property line, so that greatly increased the size of the yard.
Perfect. All right, let's talk about pavers. What did the owner do on that end?
Well, they put pavers right outside the back door. Absolutely gorgeous. And they did paver walkways to go to the pool as well as to the shed that we're at.
And one of the cool things about the shed is that it did not look like this about a month ago.
No, it's been newly refurbished. It has a brand new floor in it, fresh coat of paint, and all the handles and stuff have been redone so it can be locked and secured.
Nice. Okay, let's talk about two more big ticket items in the backyard. Kevin.
We have the pergola area right behind you, which is absolutely gorgeous. All new pavers out here as well. Fire pit behind us. And let's not forget about the pool.
And one of the big things about the pool is, again, it did not look like this about a month ago.
No, it has been completely replastered and gone through. It's good to go for the new buyer.
Perfect. So if somebody wants to set up a showing on this beautiful home, what do they do?
Well, like always, we're going to make it super simple. They can call us at 480-305-6655 or go to our website, GoSoldRealty.com.
Thank you so much for joining us today. If you have questions about buying or selling, please let us know. And until next time, have a great day.